Hello, welcome back to Call Clutter Fairy, where I help you get clutter-free so that you can live stress-free. It's starting to get a little chilly outside, which I love. This has allowed me to pull out some of our winter comforters that we put away in the spring. And as I was doing this, I thought, you know, I don't think people truly understand the amazing benefits of these space-saving storage bags. So if you've ever looked at these and wondered, are they really worth it? Do they really help? I'm going to show you why yes, yes, yes is the answer. So I use these space-saving bags in a variety of ways. I use them for my kids' clothes, not just to store them, but, you know, especially when my kids were younger, we would get things on sale ahead in sizes, or people would pass me things down and I would break them down into sizes. I would use these vacuum bags to write size 5, size 6, size 7, and I could just throw them into the vacuum bag, vacuum it out again, and keep it on a shelf. And I always used a Sharpie to write on the side so that things I could see right on the side. Oh, there's the 5s, there's the 6s, there's the 7s. It made it so easy when we would go to get dressed and I realized they've had another growth spurt, to grab those clothes, know what size they were ahead of time, but most importantly, know that they were clean and ready to be worn. This also helped as my kids would grow out of things. I would just keep a couple of bags around, and as they would grow out of a size, I would throw it into that bag, clean them, vacuum seal it, and then pass it on to the next parent who needed clothes for their kids. Another way that I really like using these is for the decorative pillows. I have a ton of decorative pillows and I really love changing things out. Some of mine just have the sleeve on the outside, which is great. I just have the insert that stays on my couch all the time. But I do have a few, like the ones I'm about to show you in a few minutes, that are large and they don't allow you to change. So instead of just keeping these big, bulky pillows that would be taking up what very little closet space I have, I use the vacuum bags on these. So one of the main things that these bags do is they keep everything clean and fresh. No dust is getting on anything. No little creepy crawlies are getting anything. If you live in a climate where there's a lot of humidity, everything is staying dry so you don't have to worry about mildew. They're fantastic. Another trick that I do is I'll take a cotton ball and I will put just the tiniest bit, I mean tiny, like half a drop of essential oil. I'll put it in at the bottom, and then when I vacuum the air out, everything is filled with this lovely aroma, and it's not wet, so it doesn't cause any moisture to sit inside the bag. When I open those bags, however many months later, it smells lovely and fresh and is ready to go. So let me show you how I use these bags and talk about some of the things you should be looking for if you want to use them. Say hello to Domino. Domino's my helper. There are a couple of different sizes, and I always suggest getting a size bigger than what you need, because when these fail, it's typically because as we are trying to shove things into the bag, our hands scrape the side, and that scraping causes the teeniest, tiniest tear or rip, and they're no longer airtight. So make sure that you are getting a size bigger so that you have plenty of room to get your hands in there and allow you to get things flat without it compromising. They're strong. I love these bags, but typically it's user error that just causes the tiniest bit of a tear and you don't even realize it. Once I start putting things inside the bag, the other thing that you really need to watch for is they always have a mark at the top of the bag that basically is telling you don't fill above this line. And what this does, once again, is it gives you room. You know, when you're putting things in the bag, it's expanded. So when you try and zip it, the opening is now having to bend over the contents inside, and getting that good tight seal is very difficult. So please make sure you're watching that fill line and that you're not going above it. They have that grippy that helps you seal the bag. Use that because when you're using just your fingers, it's a little difficult and you don't necessarily feel that all of them are tightening. Use that sealer that comes with it and then just check to see if it's completely closed. Then get your vacuum out and start vacuuming. getting that air out is kind of satisfying to watch. Now, I always get on top of mine because as it's vacuuming, by simple compression, everything is sucking towards the middle, and I like my things as flat as possible. So I stay on top to keep it flat, and that way as the air is coming out, it has no choice but to go thin. So check out how much space I got from this. So here's three of my 18 by 18 inch pillows from my couch. They were 19 inches wide, just having three of them put together. So if I were to put this in one of my storage cabinets above my closet, that would literally be my entire cabinet. It's just those three pillows. So same thing, I'm going to get them in, and you can see right now it's a little bit tight, so I'm trying to be very careful so that I don't accidentally scratch that plastic and basically put a tear in it. If you're doing these, take off rings or turn them to the inside so when your hand is going in, it's as smooth as possible. I probably should have gone for a bigger size on this one, but I only bought the extra large for this. So, so once you get that seal completely tightened, and make sure, get the vacuum bag out. I'm going to go ahead and climb on it once again because it's starting to pull inwards and I want it to stay flat. So I'm going to just put my knees on top of it to make it stay flat. And I will show you the size difference between when we started at 19 inches and where we ended up. So now that it's all done, it has shrunk down to a whopping 4 inches. We saved 15 inches worth of space just by using one of these Space Saver bags. The last thing that I'm going to show you are my beach towels. I store those at the end of summer because we literally don't use them at all during the winter. And if I keep them in my cabinet, I'm just going to have to wash them again at the beginning of summer because of dust and because I am a bug phobic. So I put them in the cube. Most of the large sized cubes have pleated bottoms, which is great for storing towels because they'll stand upright. Now, towels are obviously more dense than the feather pillows and the comforters, so they're not going to compress as much, but they will compress. And once again, they're going to be clean, bug-free, dust-free, moisture-protected. So when I put them away, I am completely confident come next spring that my towels are ready to go. So they do carry these space bags or something very similar to it at the Dollar Tree. And you know me, I love the Dollar Tree. They're good. They're fine. The mill of plastic is a little bit thinner. That's number one. They do not have the vacuum suction. So what happens is there's a hole on these, a plastic valve. Actually, hold on. So what they come with is this little plastic valve on there, and it just has a tiny little lip on here, and inside of that is a plastic valve that keeps air from going in. So here's the inside of the valve, and there's a tiny little rubber film that's going over here that when the air is being sucked out or pressed out, because that's an option as well, the valve lifts up and the air can come out. And as soon as it stops, the valve locks in place again so air can't go back in. So that's the design of these. The Ziploc space bags had patented this little valve system. There are some other generic bags out there that have this, but the benefit of the valve is it really does allow you to use a vacuum and get rid of all of that air. I'm going to set this down so hopefully it's not loud. Now, you can do the same thing with a regular Ziploc or an oversized storage bag. And what you would just need to do is leave a tiny space up at the top and roll as much air out as you can. And then while it's still rolled up, finish sealing it. And when you open it up, it will have the same suction effect of not letting air back in. But literally, the difference between rolling air out and suctioning it out with a vacuum is a pretty significant amount. So if you have a lot to store, take advantage of the valves. Now, the Dollar Tree does sell these storage bags and they're pretty decent. But again, they don't have the valve on it. The mill of plastic is a little bit thinner, so you really have to be careful. The biggest drawback to the Dollar Tree storage bags is they just don't have the sizes that you would get by buying the Ziploc storage bags. Now, you can find these Ziploc storage space bags pretty much everywhere. I know I've seen them at Bed Bath & Beyond, which is great. You can use your 20% off coupon. I know they have them in Walmart. They typically sell them in packs, though, so if you just need one or two, you need to watch to see what you need. And I know they sell them at Target. So I typically will kind of get an idea of what's going in at first and measure it. And then the box will say the dimensions right on it. Do not get the same size. Get it bigger. And that way you cannot accidentally scratch it as you're trying to jam extra in there. And the seals will be perfect. Now, I'd love to know what you think about these storage bags. If you use them in your own home, please leave me a comment how and what things have worked well for you. If you're new to my channel, welcome. Thank you so much for watching. If you're returning, I love you guys. You are absolutely the brightest part of my day. I so love reading all of your comments and love interacting with you. So I thank you for your support. Make sure you do hit that subscribe button if you haven't already. That tells YouTube what kind of content you like to see, but it also tells me which ones you really like, and it keeps me motivated to record. I will see you next week with a new video. Bye.